to all the things you did. Don't you know in this life it's your chance to survive. Bring your soul alive from the past you've led. Wash away your sins, it's your chance now it is. Wash away your sins, it's your chance now it is. To be amongst the winners from above.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome again for a great episode, inshallah ta'ala, to be among al-fa'izun. But tonight, we are going to be talking about a very interesting topic. It's among those who choose in the middle of the night to be standing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their hearts are connected to use a very specific time that is blessed to Allah to be al-fa'izun. To be among al-qa'imun, people who stand up in the middle of the night to pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are matching a very important time that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this time will come down to the earth sky and will say, هَلْ مِن مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرُ لَهُ. Is there someone standing in prayer, making dua, making supplication and asking for forgiveness, so I shall grant it to him? This is your chance. This is your time, because as the Prophet spoke about the importance of this time, it is about honor and dignity. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ شَرَفَ الْمُؤْمِنِ قِيَامَ اللَّيْلِ, that your true honor is that when you stand for Allah in the middle of night praying. Why? Because it's something you did on your own. It is something that matches your way of being introduced as a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, engaged in the concept of worship toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is that will be waiting for you? Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken in his book.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Tatajafa junubuhum anil madaji'i yad'una rabbahum khawfan wa tama'a wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqun. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
In this last verse, Allah is saying that they don't know what really is waiting for them in heaven. The Prophet even speaks about that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فِيهَ مَا لَعَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. That in heaven, there are things you have never even thought of. It is not just that. It is also a mean for all your rewards to be high up. And the Prophet ﷺ spoke about that. Shall I tell you about what brings your level high up in rewards at the Day of Judgment? He spoke about الصدقة تطفئ الخطيئة كما يطفئ الماء النار. And then he said, وصلاة الليل صلاة الرجل من جوف الليل. That when you stand in the middle of the night and you pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the true reward. And not just that, your dua will be answered. Your supplications are more likely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond for them. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that there is an hour in the night. If a servant of Allah matches that time to stand in prayer and ask Allah dua, Allah will answer his dua for that. Why? Because everyone else is sleeping and you chose to stand up and make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to invest to be among al-winners, al-qa'imun, and that's how you can do it, by staying in the night to be among al-fa'izun, inshallah. Inshallah ta'ala, we will all be among people who are al-qa'imun in this blessed month of Ramadan. But doing that, what does it really mean? It means that you are following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He always maintained salat al-layl. He always maintained to stand up in this blessed time and pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, read Quran and do dua and supplication. He was living the words of the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Ya ayyuhal muzammil qumil layla illa qalila nisfahu aw inqus minhu qalila أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا.
Even Sahaba, were joining the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for a whole year until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eased it on them and made it not that they have to stand for the whole night. So when we are practicing Qiyam al-Layl, we are looking up to the Prophet as our role model, as our example sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and following his steps. Number two, when you stand up in the night and you practice Qiyam al-Layl, you will be considered among those who purify themselves from all the sins and will enter heaven inshallah without any hisab. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam spoke about that. It will be called on all these people who perform Salah and Qiyam al-Layl, and they will be given a granted passage into heaven without their accounts being held against them at the Day of Judgment. Not just that, when we talk about Qiyam al-Layl, Al-Qa'imun, we are talking about people, inshallah ta'ala, who will be responding to a comprehensive understanding of Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Afshu as-salam, spread peace. وَأَطْعِمُ الطَّعَامِ فِي الدَّنِيدِ وَصَلُّوا بِالْلَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامِ Pray in the night when people are sleeping. تَدْخُلُوا جَنَّةَ رَبِّكُمْ بِسَلَامِ For that you will enter heaven inshallah ta'ala in peace. So when you are praying in the middle of the night, Allah will grant you heaven in peace. And listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع يدعون ربهم خوفا وطمعا ومما رزقناهم ينفقون فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون
That there will be special preparation for you waiting, things that you have never seen or experienced in life before. This is what will be waiting for you if you are among the people of Al-Qa'imun, who stand up in the middle of the night. Choose the time when everyone is sleeping. You wake up, you make your wudu, you face the Kaaba, and you pray, and you ask for forgiveness, and you will be among the winners, insha'Allah ta'ala. Inshallah ta'ala, we will be all among those who stand up in the night and perform salah to be among al-qa'imun. But when we do that, what does it mean? It means, one, that we are following the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He always maintained salat qiyam al-layl. And he always prayed, and in that he was responding to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told him to do.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. يا أيها المزمل قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا
That he was practicing what he was been told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Sahaba, for the first year, they would always make Qiyam al-Layl all night long. Not after that year finished, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for them. But doing that, even when we are responding to the call of Allah, trying to follow the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people think of, okay, the Prophet, all his sins were forgiven. Even that was mentioned by his wife Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha. She said, Ya Rasulullah, you made Qiyam al-Layl and Allah forgave all your sins. Why? Until your feet are so sore. The Prophet's response was, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا If that is the ni'mah, that is the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted me, why I wouldn't be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To thank Him for this blessing that He forgave all my sins. Keep that in mind, that also when you are responding to the call of Allah and praying in the night, inshallah ta'ala, you will be pure. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that at the Day of Judgment, people who maintain Qiyam al-Layl will be asked to enter heaven without any hisab. Yunadaw. They will be called upon. Where are the people who used to make Qiyam al-Layl? Here you can enter heaven without your accounts are held against you. And again, one last thing is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Afshu as-salam, spread peace. Wa at'imu at-ta'am, and feed the needy. Wa sallu bil-layli wan-nasu niyam. Pray in the night when everyone is sleeping. What will happen? Tadkhulu jannata rabbikum bi-salam. You will be able to enter heaven in peace. This is what we want. We want to please Allah. We want to enter into heaven, and not just to enter into heaven, in peace, in tranquility. Something like a ni'mah, a blessing from Allah has been given to you. You are following the steps of the Prophet ﷺ. You are being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are purified from your sins, and at the same time, you are introducing yourself to the dimensions of Islam, feeding the needy, praying in the night, spreading peace, and in that, you are among, inshallah, those who are the winners. الفائزون.